Hello everyone, today we're going to talk about a subject that I find fascinating, which is the way we can use SVG files in React and the way they work particularly well together. The point of origin of this interest was work I had to do on a website for H&M where we had to create a dynamic map where when we had different projects with different states and different types of projects, and the types of the projects and the states would change depending on a number of things of how completed they were. There were different ways of doing this. We could have just created image files with transparency, PNG files, and created 20 odd files, but I started looking into how SVGs worked in React. What I found was really interesting, and it was something I didn't know. Okay, let's get using SVGs with React JS. So we have 5 reasons to use SVGs and 4 ways to use them in React. Now, the 5 reasons to use SVGs. Because SVGs can be light. A properly done SVG, which doesn't have an excessive amount of details, can be in the 1 kilobyte, 2 kilobytes, where an equivalent PNG file would be at least 10 times as big. Now, this is not an absolute rule. I've seen PNG files that were very heavy in details and that were half a meg in size. But in general, for a simple illustration, for an icon, for anything that's vectorial, a SVG is the perfect fit and will make your network load a lot lighter and make your website load faster, which is a good thing. The second thing is SVGs can be scaled. We can have the same file look good at small size and a big size, because as it's vectorial content, it's vectors, it's basically the same thing. The icon that we have on screen here is a vectorial content. It will scale up simply. It's not a load of pixels that trying to make a circle. It's in code we say this is actually a circle, this is actually a line. And so this means that it ends up looking good a lot better at higher resolutions and at higher scales. The third thing is SVG files can be styled. We can apply CSS styles. We can apply CSS styles to SVG files. We can apply a number of things, which means that they can take on different styles depending on the context, depending on the logic, which means we can have SVG files that change color depending on if the item is active in the icon in the menu, for example. And so the fact that we can change the image dynamically in code is really important. That's something we can't do with a PNG, for example. We can do a filter, but that's going to be heavy. It's not going to have a good color. Whereas here we can say, this outline, this class has this color. And that can be done dynamically in code. SVG files can also be animated. Because there's a logical content and the way it's done, we can say, okay, this part here, we can change its length, we can change its curvature, we can change it and so on. And so this allows us to animate SVG files in a way which is not possible with PNG files, and which is lightweight as well. Lastly, SVG files are basically text files, and the fact that they are basically text files mean that they can be indexed, and so they can be useful for SEO. They can also be useful for the same reasons for translation. That's slightly more complicated because text files have different words have different sizes in different languages. But basically, if you're in a context where you must have text in an image, and I would recommend against using text in an image in 95% of the cases, but if you absolutely must have text in an image and that you know that the size is going to be safe, you can use your translation, and if you need to have it translated, obviously, you can use the translation, underlying translation of what your framework, of, for example, of React, and use that to inject text inside the SVG and that have that text be translated. So 5 reasons, 6 if you can translation, why it's a good idea to use SVGs. That said, how do we use SVGs? Well, there are 4 ways to do so. The simple way, and the way we're most used to, is to have a simple, just include it like any other image file. Do an image tag with the src equals and go and fetch it on the server. Now the problem with that is that we're fetching it on the server and that we're actually not making use of a number of the good things that I mentioned before. We can actually also use the logo directly inside from import it into our React component. And this is actually what the Create React App start page does. The app actually basically has this code here. And if you do a Create React App, you can see it for yourself. I've simplified it. I've moved out some of the fluff, which is not relative to the subject at hand. But basically, this means that it's a lot nicer way of writing things, but it's basically the same thing that's happening. That is, it's basically fetching a file from the server. For other image files of other formats other than SVG, so PNGs and stuff, when the file is less than 10 kilobytes in size, React will actually inline the content, so write it inside the as data inside the SRC attribute of the image tag. But this is not true for SVG files. There's a bug that prevents it from happening. We're still doing a round trip to the server with SVG files, and round trips to the servers are generally a bad idea. Now there's another better way of using SVGs, which is to use a library called SVGR, and you can look up how to install it. I'll have it, I'll include a link in the comments. This allows you to transform SVGs files into React components. And this transformation means that you no longer have a round trip to the server. It means you can basically do, as we have in line 2, import React component as logo from an SVG file and then use that logo directly as a component. The advantages it has is, like I said, you're no longer doing a round trip to the server, so it's better in terms of speed and responsiveness of your application. It also means that the styles are better applied. So it's an all-round, it's a good solution. And for most use cases, for a lot of use cases, it's largely sufficient. However, for my use case with the map that I talked about initially, it's not sufficient. I needed to be able to apply logic and to apply conditional styling and stuff like that based on what the content was that I was trying to display. And basically what the reason why SVGR works and the reason why we can do even better is because SVG files are basically just a text file. And the fact that they're just text files mean that they can be rendered by React. And in fact, they're just text files that have an XML type structure, just like HTML does. Which means that we can actually render them directly inside a component. So if we take this is the more or less the code for the React logo. On line 6, the line is actually a lot longer, so hence the etc. But this is basically what SVGR does, and in a lot of cases we can actually do it ourselves. Now, we don't always need to do it ourselves. It can be a lot faster. Just if we don't need to change the icon, if there's no logic to apply, if there's no business logic that is required, then the SVGR, which comes bundled by default in Create React App 2, by the way. But basically what it's doing is what we can do ourselves. And it's creating a render of the SVG file, basically like the text we have on screen here. Now, what does this mean? This means that we can apply all the fun stuff we do in React to this component. So this means that we can easily include a state, we can include a callback on a click that changes the state, and we can take into account that state to change the styling of the SVG. So basically this means we can have an icon that changes depending on the state of the application. So in my case, in the map, I could change the icon based on whether the project was active or not. I could change the styling. And this is actually a really powerful thing. It's not useful for every single use case, but it does allow us to do a lot of things and to do it in the natural React way, using hooks, using a component that renders the SVG. This allows us to break out the context of just HTML and to apply the same kind of React goodness to images that we include inside the SVG, inside the React. I hope that was useful or fun. It was fun for me, at least. It was an interesting subject that I haven't even completely finished exploring yet, I think. There are lots of things to discover with SVGs because they're a very powerful tool and a very useful tool. And the interesting thing for me was that how closely, how well they fit into React, how well the two can intermesh. Anyway, if you found this video interesting, if you found it fun, please feel free to like the video. In fact, please do. I appreciate the encouragement. Subscribe if you like, if you want to hear more, if you want to learn more. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Oh, and if you have any questions, any comments, any requests, for example, if you're interested in learning how we created the map component in the website I showed in the intro, let me know. Thanks, bye.